didn't come from a monster background. I came from theater and doing mostly beauty makeup, and I enjoyed the prosthetic stuff. The highlight of doing Angel, it changes every week, and that's the best part about it. I'm not stuck on a show where I'm doing just beauty makeup or just prosthetics. Every episode is just a new experience. In my department, makeup-wise, we only have two makeup artists on the show. It's myself and David DeLeon. In our trailer, we have two hairstylists also, Diana Acree and Anthony Miner. So there's only four of us that are permanent on the show.
Cordelia, what happened to your head?
Excuse me?
Your hair. It's new.
I begged and pleaded, please let me cut my hair. My head's too heavy and it takes forever. And so they said, fine, you can cut your hair. And it was a disaster. It was too bold and striking.
It's hardly noticeable.
Cordelia, what happened?
Your hair, well, looks great. What?
It didn't work. So I've gotten to go lighter now. And, you know, I have a wonderful team here. David DeLeon, who does my makeup, which I'm really pleased with. He does the airbrush thing. It's the bomb.
Oh, no.
We have a special makeup made by a fellow named John Vulich, which is the monsters and the masks and stuff. The vampires have prosthetic pieces that they wear.
The way John Vulich and I work together is John Vulich has the meetings with the producers and the writers and whoever to create the monster that they have written. They do the drawings and they get approved and then they start sculpting. After they make that piece, if it's called for, they'll pre-color it to an extent and then they'll send it to me.
I'm in awe. I don't want it on me, but I think it's fantastic on them, you know? My favorite character is the host.
We're all brothers under the skin, mi amigo. Although the garden hue and the horns have kept me out of some key public performances.
It's a time-consuming makeup, and he's a great person to work with. It's a lot of intricate detail makeup with airbrush and stuff.
Makeup process takes a long time. It takes 3 hours. My character, it takes the longest for him. It's just getting it on takes 3 hours, then the contacts, and then the hair. They spray my hair a different color.
The beginning of Andy's makeup, it starts with a prosthetic that's a full face. It goes all over his face, from his hairline all the way under his chin. It's a very fine piece, so it's very thin, and that's why it's so time-consuming to get that first piece on. After that, then I just paint it with what we call a PAX paint, cover him with that and his neck and ears. Then the next step for me is I put on an airbrush makeup that's another color of green that I spray his whole face, that piece, his eyes, his ears, his neck, everything, his hands that are exposed. I spray that green on everything. And then after that, I go into another layer of makeup, which is a darker green, forest green makeup, just to start giving it some texture around his cheeks and his brows and around his horns and stuff. Then after that, I go and use what they call a transparent black. So it's not really dark. It just starts giving more detail, more dark texture. And while I'm doing this, while I have each color out, I go to his hands and I'll do his hands with the green and the black. I just go to his face and his hands and just keep one color running at a time. After that, I use reds around his eye and color his horns red. Then after I get all that detail done and the red and the black around his eyes, then I put a highlighter on, which is a yellow color that just kind of brings the highs back on his nose and around his horns and stuff like that. And then it goes and has his hair done, and then he has his contacts put in, and we do the last minute touch up and off we go. He's very patient. He gets a little wiggly sometimes, but I'll just bust him and tell him to sit still and he's okay. He laughs at me.
When he's doing the glue around my mouth, I have to be quiet for like 40 minutes, which is torturous for me. But the rest of the time we go back and forth, and there's usually always lots of other people in there from the hair and makeup department, so we get to tell stories. It's fun. It's the funnest place to be on set.
Being affiliated with a great makeup crew, even starting with Buffy, with Todd, and then going on to Dane's, it's just been a great transition because it was important for me to feel comfortable with that, and he's been phenomenal. They create these creatures that are just unbelievable every week.
God, I have never looked so beautiful and so hideous all at the same time. My face for Darla, my sculpted piece, I think is one of the most evil-looking vampires. When they put the makeup on me, and I looked in the mirror and I smiled, and I went, wow, that's scary.
Gung-ho, are they? Because all I'm sensing right now is big, stinky fear.
it's amazing what how the prosthetics can bring to life a character. And as an actor, it really takes the pressure off.
Make it stop, please. I was an angel. And he's gone. He's all gone.
Dane did the makeup, and it was just really upsetting, actually, to see that burn makeup, because it was really incredibly well done.
If you notice in the Shroud of Ramon episode, there's a demon played by Tony Todd that the makeup is dynamic. I mean, he's got this spine that comes out on the outside of his body and goes all the way down to his back. And the hair, if you see that demon, you'll see how great their makeup is. So they work very hard and do a fantastic job. And not to mention me, I mean, you know, I'm really white, you know. They hook this makeup up tight, you know. They make me look good, too, so they're good.